So I mentioned that our fire alarm systems have to be tested every year as required by the fire code. So it is the fire alarm technician that is permitted to do these testing requirements. So as a fire alarm technician, some of the tools that you will need to test the system is a multimeter, for example. So a multimeter is a device that is used to measure voltage, resistance, and current. It helps us with testing our fire alarm system. It helps us determine if a circuit is in proper working condition. Fire alarm technician, in addition to coming out and doing the annual testing requirements, they would also be called out if the system is malfunctioning or has a fault or a trouble on it. So they would get called out and their multimeter will help them determine what type of fault it is, where that fault could be, and how they can fix the fault. In addition to our multimeter, we use tools such as a decibel reader, like the one you're seeing right there. This tells us how loud the environment is right now, and then it will also show us how loud the alarm tones are when they come on. So if I was to turn on our system here, you should see that sound level increase with our alarm. So our building codes again is what tells us how loud those alarm tones should be. So as a fire alarm technician, you would test to make sure that the minimum requirements are met. So in addition to the testing requirements we just spoke about, and also in addition to testing all of our input and output devices, we would also test the functions of the panel itself. So this is a pretty basic panel where we've got, silencing our audibles out in the field, resetting the system, but where we have more complex systems with voice communication, different multi-zones, we would have to, again, during those annual testing requirements, we would have to test all the functions of the fire alarm system to make sure that they're all in working order. With our battery, so you can see here, our batteries provide backup power to our fire alarm system. So my panel always has power in case of a power failure. So if I remove this, you can hear my system going into trouble because we're missing the batteries. So again, as part of the annual testing requirements, we can test our batteries to make sure there's enough power to serve my system. So we can do that with this little battery tester here. If I hook this up. Oops. We can see that this particular battery provides 13.64 volts and 3.3 amp hours. So there is a calculation that the technician would do to see if that, that battery is sufficient for this panel. So that wraps up our video of our CFAA fire alarm technician responsibilities and a little bit about our fire alarm systems and how they operate.